Hello and welcome. Today we're gonna add subscribe buttons to Shotcut, little reminders, little notifications in the video, pop-ups you can call them, basically animated graphics. And to do this, we're gonna use one method with only Shotcut and one method where we use an external image editing tool, for example, GIMP or Inkscape. We're going to start by dragging in some video. Let's get this one and enable the timeline, drag this to a timeline. And next up, what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a color clip. Let's go to File, Open Other, go to Color in the Generator category, and we're gonna pick the color, which will be of 0 alpha value, and let's make it black background. All right, we're gonna pick that, press OK. Here we have it. Let's zoom out in the timeline and drag it to the timeline. Press Home or Pause 1 to get to the beginning and get rid of the rest. Move stuff around. We're going to create another video track too. I'm going to move this transparent thing to the top and the actual video to the bottom. And now we're going to just add the text filter. So let's go to Filters. While this is selected for transparent clip, press a plus, go to Video Filters, and scroll down alphabetically to text. There we go. And what we're gonna do is, let's see, we're gonna extend this view a little. We're gonna write something like, just subscribe to Tux. And it's gonna be white on red. So background is gonna be red. All right. And we're gonna add some padding. 100 is max, so let's just use 100. That's good enough. Center doesn't really matter. Let's keep it at the bottom. We're gonna now add the the rotate filter, right. Where is it? RS, rotate, here it is. Let's add it and put the scale down to, yeah, like that. Maybe a little less. This is good. Yeah, 60% is nice. And now, to animate this, we want it to come into the screen and then go away. Let's add another filter. We're going to add size and position. All right, this thing has keyframes, so let's press the keyframes button. Let's drag the keyframes to the left. Let me show you this clearly. I'm grabbing the keyframes tab by the keyframes word, moving it around a little, and then it can snap to different areas. And we're going to snap it to this area. Okay, now we have two timelines. This is the keyframe timeline, and this is the timeline. And what we want is to, we want this thing to come into the screen, let's say over the course of 1 second, and then disappear over the course of maybe 2 seconds. So there are no default values yet. So let's jump to the very first frame. And position, well, we want it to come from below, so let's put it to maybe, let's go for 1000. And then we jump to the center, that's a bit high, let's set this to 100. Oh, my bad. Not a number, come on. 100 on the y axis. Same here, let's get rid of that. 0 and 1000. Let's play this back. All right, that's pretty much what I wanted. And now at the very end, let's put this back to 1000. And if we play it all back, let's disable the video in the background for now so we can hopefully see it better performance. Subscribe to Tux comes into the screen. All right. And then it goes out of the screen. So that's how simple it is, how simple it can be to add such a graphic. Now we're gonna do the same, but with an image file, so you can see how much better it is. The quality is just better, especially if you want to use something that you use again and again, prepare an image, much better. I am going to use Inkscape for this. It's free and open source. And first up, we're gonna go to File and Document Properties. And here we're gonna set this to pixels, and landscape, and Not, well, depending on your video size, it might be different, but most commonly it's 1920 by 1080. And let's just close it. Here's our thing. Let's just use the rectangle tool, F4, to create a square. And I think these things are usually not visible, so I don't actually know how to reach this from here. Anyways, just press Ctrl-Shift-F or Command-Shift-F on Mac, maybe. And in here you can set the color of the fill using this or this. I prefer HSL. You can also use the wheel, for example. Not a fan. We're going to add some rounding to this. Let's add 2 millimeters. You can set this to pixels as well. Yeah, maybe 16 pixels. All right. Now we're going to add a font. Just going to add this. Sub to Tux. This is very small. We can enter a number here. Let's go for 128. That's too much. We can pick a different font in here. Let's go good old Bibas Neue. All right, now with this tool, we're going to drag it to down here. And this is good. Making it white. And now we're going to select both of holding Shift, and Control-Shift-A is going to add the align and distribute thing. So let's just align all of these relative to page centered. Now we can select both and press Control-G to group them. And now holding Control, we can... Holding Control, we can drag things on one axis. So I think this is quite good. Maybe make it a bit smaller. Yeah, this is pretty good. So now we're going to export this. Let's go to File, Export, Export PNG Image. Make sure to pick the right path and give it a file name. Make sure to hit Page, not Drawing, because we don't want this little thing to be exported. We want the whole page to be exported. So now just Export. We can also save this file if we want to reuse it later. File, Save. Just going to call it sub. It will get v.svg ending automatically. And we can close it. And now in Shotcut, we can just drag the PNG image into the view area and drag it to a timeline again. Okay. I think we're going to actually... Yeah, let's just copy all these. Use this. Click on this. And, hopefully it won't crash. Paste. We don't need text. We don't need rotate. Only size and position is interesting. So let's just move this a bit to the side. And move this to the left. Okay, cool. I think this might actually work. Nice! Only thing, we don't want it to be 100 pixels down, since we already perfectly aligned the image. So let's start again. Once without the background video. Sub to Tux. And... What was that? Okay, I don't know why this is 100. Let's set this to 1000 again. There we go. And with the background image, we can now perfectly see everything. All right, so this is how you add a little notification, subscribe to me, banner. Make sure it's not too extremely annoying, not too extremely obnoxious, not too extremely in the center. Doesn't show for it way too long. But this is a different topic, really. I'm just here to show you how to use stuff, how to create stuff, but how you use it is, of course, your thing. So, what the... Again. For some reason, again, it's at 100... Size and position. 69. Why is it 69? Let's try to fix it. And at the end, it is still at 1000. Okay, seems to be fixed. All right, cool. And of course, if you are not aware, you just have to press export and scroll down and hit the export file button. And then give this file a name. Output, for example, .mp4. Keep the mp4. And then just wait for this progress bar to finish. And once that's done, you will have your thing. And I should have removed this, because we don't need to export this at all. Oh well. Yeah, let's stop this job, remove, and export again. Much faster. So again, thank you for checking this out. I hope this video is helpful. Give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if anything else you can be helped with. And I will see you in the next video. Until then, ciao.